One evening as the sun went down and the jungle fire was burning, down the track came a hobo hiking, and he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away beside the crystal fountains. So come with me, we'll go and see the big rock candy mountains. In the big rock candy mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright."
Hi, I'm Heather.
Hi, I'm Brooklyn.
Hi, I'm Matthew.
We are here to tell you about the new journey we've embarked on in the mountains of North Carolina, 45 minutes northwest of Asheville. We have been blessed with the opportunity to caretake a 500-acre Appalachian sanctuary of flora and fauna called the Hostel of the Mountain. As well as being our new home, this extraordinary property holds 7 natural springs, 2 grassy balds, 360-degree views of one of the oldest mountain ranges in the world, countless edible and medicinal plants, lichens, and mushrooms, a deciduous forest of beech, oak, maple, black locust, and eastern white pine, and abundant wildlife, including black bear, wild boar, white-tailed deer, woodpeckers, groundhogs, and of course, our faithful mouse catchers, Atlas and Fable. The diversity of species of plants for both wild foraged food and medicine is outstanding, such as reishi mushroom, the cancer-fighting powerhouse, and chickweed, both a tasty salad green and a bright cure for everything from coughs to obesity to tumors. All these treasures of the land and more you will see on the 2.5-mile hike from the base to the top of the mountain, where we live and host guests and travelers from near and far, in an off-the-grid cabin between the 2 sandy mush balds. Our warmth and meals are thanks to our trusty wood stove, and our nights are lit up by candles and kerosene lamps. At this point, you might be thinking, what more could they possibly want? Well, despite the mountain supplying most of our community's basic needs, the biggest hurdle preventing us from achieving true self-reliance and sustainability is being able to grow and raise our own food. To do this, we are asking for your help in supporting us as we take on 3 big projects.
Our future mountain garden space is more than just a place where food is grown. Intended to be used as a working collaboration project between guests and caretakers alike, the vegetables are just an added bonus. 16 by 20 in size, it appears quite small compared to the 500 acres available, but with various permaculture designs in place, sizes of no matter. Necessary to be protected not only from the copious wildlife that inhabit this land, but also from the frequent high-speed winds that dominate the landscape. Trees located on the south end provide windbreak that works in unison with the wooden slat fence to come. Inside will harbor the first 4 raised beds, all to be constructed of stones from this property, a rewarding endeavor for using as many natural resources appropriate to this land and the extra labor it will require. The stone beds will retain heat for longer and maintain their structural integrity indefinitely. Our soil is already rich and dark, so we will have no problems planting even our earliest crops into the beds. Come mid to late spring, we will have already begun to produce and harvest vegetables, such as kale, lettuce greens, and radishes. The first start to providing visitors with the freshest food available, which is where you come in. Our garden still needs some lumber for the wall, supplemental seed supply, straw for mulch, and all the tools necessary to keep a garden running smoothly. Thank you.
Chickens and their eggs are going to be one of our main sources of protein and entertainment here on the mountain. I've cared for a flock of about 70 hens and chicks before, but the mountain poses its own unique challenges to birds roosting at our 4,800-foot elevation. Luckily, there's a hardy Chilean breed that we know can make it up here. Araucanas are known to be good wild foragers, weather-hardy, and tough in even the coldest of winds due to their fuzzy earmuffs, tufts, and beards. And to ensure their survival and an overeasy breakfast, we will be constructing our flock a protected poultry palace near the main lodge. This project requires chicken wire and lumber to build the run, and later we will welcome in our brood with a cozy straw-lined nesting area and organic grain food. With some tender care and chicken shepherding, our future flock will be settled by Easter, just in time to enjoy Arikana's naturally blue eggs.
Hi, I'm Matthew. I'm here to talk to you about our future greenhouse building project. As Brooklyn already mentioned, our growing season here is especially short, so we need all the help we can get in establishing a self-sustainable community here on the mountain. Our plan is to build a 6x10 attached greenhouse to the south-facing side of the lodge. It's been shown that houses with an attached greenhouse are 20 to 30% more efficient due to its passive solar. This means less time and energy spent harvesting fuel for a wood stove and warmer nights for us. Secondly, our plan is to build a vent at the base and the ceiling. This will allow cold air to come in through the bottom, be warmed by the sun, and then re-enter the house through the top, eliminating our need for a fan and making for happier plants. Secondly, Sandy Mushbald has no shortage of stones. In an effort to reduce cost, our plan is to spend many hours of backbreaking labor harvesting granite and quartz to build a solid foundation and a 2-foot base around the bottom of the greenhouse. This thermal mass will allow for more rapid heating in the daytime and heat retention during cool nights. And then finally, we're going to tap into our gutters to install a rainwater catchment system with an overflow valve that leads to our gray water system for watering the plants. So where do you come in? While we do plan on harvesting lumber for the corner and roof poles, we need help with the lumber for the floor, mortar for the stones, and the fiberglass sheeting for the walls and the ceiling. With your help, I believe we can become a self-sustainable community here on the mountain.
And you sleep out every night where the boxcars all are empty and the sun shines every day on the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees, the lemonade springs where the bluebird sings in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, all the cops have wooden legs and the bulldogs...